Time for our feature interview here on Blitz. I'm Brian Carter, joined at this time by Lee Shaw, head coach of the Raven County Wildcats. Coach, it's always an honor just to sit down and talk football with you. One of our favorite coaches that we get to be around, and just thank you so much for your time.
I appreciate being on the show with you. You've done a tremendous job of covering high school kids and making football teams feel special, yeah. And we appreciate that.
It's the pleasure is all mine for sure, especially awesome. Being around your program the last few years. And I have to imagine that this is, going to a state championship game is in itself quite a feat. But to be able to come back and do that for your alma mater, this has to be a dream come true for you.
You know, I think back when I played high school ball here at Raven County, I always wanted to be the head football coach mm-hmm. and do something special for Raven County, not just for Lee Shaw, but for Raven County.
Right.
And it was truly a dream come true for the county, for our players, for this coaching staff, and for myself.
Yeah, that's actually exactly where I was going next, is with the community. Wildcat Nation, unbelievable this year and the years past too, but it's really cool to see how you guys kind of feed off of each other. You know, the community rallies around the team and they're proud of what goes on and off the field, and vice versa, it seems like that pumps a lot more energy into the team mm-hmm. as well. What can you say about this community of Raven County?
Just awesome. They believe when I came back in 2012, the first thing I talked about was believing again, mm-hmm. that there is tradition here. We just got to scratch the surface and get it back. And they bought into it. And, of course, having some success early helped that.
Yeah.
But then our players, the community started believing in each other.
Mm-hmm.
It became bigger than a football game. It became something special for everybody that ever played the game here, and that we're Wildcats, and we embrace the fact that it's a Wildcat Nation.
Yeah.
And we didn't forget about them.
Yeah.
And they didn't forget about us, and it became, when we won, everybody won.
Yeah.
And that's a special feeling, because when you love each other and you love your community, you love your school, the team, the coaches, I think this program was built on love, really, especially mm-hmm. this year.
Yeah, you could definitely feel it, too. And you could feel the brotherhood. I know we talk a lot about it. Even as much as it's been talked about, I think it's underplayed, because there's a lot of people out there that would say that's one of those intangibles that you can't really see it, and maybe it doesn't translate into wins, losses. And you and I know that's not the case. I mean,
yeah.
It goes a long way. How big of an impact does this brotherhood have?
Yeah, you can break it down on brotherhood, and you can talk about brotherhood, but if you really don't love each other,
mm-hmm.
and the coaches love the players and they can tell them that, and the player love the coaches and they can tell them about that, and you have players also saying, you know, man, I'm gonna miss you, I love you.
Yeah.
And they meant it, it becomes bigger than just that football game, because they want to play not only for themselves but for their teammate.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where the brotherhood is kind of formed. And then, of course, they suffer together.
Yeah.
You know, whatever that means for the program, whether it's team camps or summer conditioning, or they learn to suffer together, and that creates a bond like no other.
Mm-hmm.
So when we talked about brotherhood, it became deeper than just that. It became embracing all those guys like myself and some of the coaches on staff that played here that – all the way to 1949
mm-hmm.
when this program was started, that you're playing for those guys. And don't forget about those guys. That's our heritage. That's our tradition. That's now the Wildcat Nation.
Mm-hmm.
And so the brotherhood became really deep in a sense that we were playing for everybody that ever put on that helmet since 1949.
I imagine, too, that, like you said, the players playing for something bigger than themselves, playing for something bigger than the game of football, allows them to really tap into that next gear that somehow, you know, some people can't find that next gear, but to me, the great players find that when they are able to tap into something deeper than just their skills.
Absolutely, and I think that goes back full circle back to they're playing for each other.
Mm-hmm.
And when you play for each other, you don't want to let your best friend down, your teammate down.
Yeah.
And you're held accountable at a higher standard. Mm-hmm. And this football team definitely got that.
Yeah, like you said, it's bigger than the game as well. And Currahee, from what I understand, is a big part of what you guys do, a tradition here at Raven County. How much does that kind of play into the whole brotherhood aspect?
Yeah, I started that going to camp there in Toccoa and then running Curry Mountain and the whole mojo behind that at Flowery Branch. Yeah. And it was a really cool blueprint for success for us. And I just implemented it when I got here at Rabun County, and the players bought into it, and that's our battle cry is Curry He. And it means something. I won't go into everything that we do because
yeah,
it's really really special. And it's about that group that, that we're playing with at that time. So,
yeah.
But it's one of those things that is team camp. It's tough. It's where the bonding happens, where Curry He happens, where the brotherhood happens. So I'd hate to not be able to go to a camp like Curry He.
Yeah.
And starting my football season.
Absolutely. I mean, it's part of your recipe. Now tell me about Sharpen the Sword. That was kind of the motto this year, and I couldn't help but notice, covering your team for so long, back in, I think it was 2009, you had Sharpen the Blade with the Flyer Branch.
You remember that.
I remember that. Yeah, so same number of letters, the 15 letters.
Yeah.
But, you know, what was that, the significance to Sharpen the Sword for the team this year, and how did they kind of own that?
Yeah, just as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. And we all, every coach has a word of the week. And Sharpen the Sword was an acronym. Every letter stood for a word that, and I won't go into detail with that, that coach would present during that week of Word of the Week, and then they would just go off on their own deal talking about that word, and I would, quite honestly, I would think about it all year and come up with the motto and then pray over what word to be used for that week and what coach needed to bring the word, and it just kind of all meshed together, and it just falls into place, and it was basically sharpening each other, sharpening your skill set, sharpening everything that you had to do really to go into battle on a Friday night.
Like Ezekiel 21:11, I think is what y'all tied that to.
Absolutely.
Definitely, that was pretty fascinating to see that. And I'm sure it was no coincidence that 15 for 15 games, you want to get to that state championship.
Absolutely.
And so this is, again, your second time making it to the state championship game. One of the only coaches in state history to take two programs to a state title game. What were the similarities that you see when you look back at the 2008 Flyer Branch Falcons, 2017 Rabun County Wildcats?
Yeah, I think one is both teams played with relentless effort and believed in each other. And we had several D1 players on that Flyer Branch team.
Yeah.
It was a loaded up team, but it was all both teams believed that they could get to the point that they were at. You know, everybody talks about, I want to win a state championship. Well, do you really want to win a state championship? And how deep does that go? Are you fully committed to do everything that it takes to win a state championship, prepare for a state championship, believe in that? And our players believed in, since Curry He camp, when they said, we're going to win a state championship, we knew we had something special.
Yeah. And I know after the state finals game against Hapeville Charter, you gathered the guys together and you said, this is going to hurt for a while.
Yeah.
How do you process that? Because I know it's painful, but there's absolutely a dream season for you guys.
Well, I think all of us, it takes you a little while to decompress and really kind of realize what was accomplished. You hate losing because it's a bad taste in your mouth, and you have to wait all year, whether you're training and preparing, but you still got to wait to that first game to get that win and get it out of your mouth. It's just difficult. It's still difficult, but what I'm most proud about this football team and in that game is they never quit. They never gave up. This football team was fighting to the last second of that game, and that's what they'll remember that.
Yeah.
They'll be disappointed in the loss, of course, and they'll always remember that, unfortunately, but they'll remember that they fought together for their brotherhood and for Rabun County to the very end.
Yeah. What was, from your perspective, the emotional roller coaster of what should have been the day of your state championship with the Mercedes-Benz debacle, learning that you guys couldn't play there, then having to wait, and you finally win your coin flip.
Yeah,
first time. And then getting that excitement back to be able to play on the home field.
You know, I took half the team, the varsity guys down, left the JV guys down to come for the next day, but took the varsity guys down on that Friday to watch a game and to dial in, much like what we did at Screven.
Mm-hmm.
And we got right to the door and I'd called the GHSA rep to make sure where we were supposed to get off at which gate. And he said, look, stay on the bus. We're about to cancel everything.
Oh, man.
So we were right there at that point to get off the bus. And so I told the team, I said, here's the situation. And, you know, everybody was disappointed for 3, 4, 5 minutes, I guess, until I explained the fact that we would now have an opportunity for a coin flip to play in Rabun County.
Yeah.
And when that happened, everybody was like, hey, let's roll. We could have this thing at home. Nobody was really disappointed. If they were, they hit it really well. And they just, that's the kind of football team we had. They just, it really wouldn't have mattered. We could play it in the parking lot.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And they would have been happy to do that. So it was a little bit of a disappointment, but once we realized that we were going to be in Rabun County and I finally got that coin flip.
Yeah, finally. Long overdue.
Yeah, long overdue. Saved the best for last,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
There was a lot of excitement within this community.
Yeah. Bailey Fisher. I mean, you told me about, I think his sophomore year, I remember you telling me here on Blitz that he was going to be one of the best you had ever had at quarterback. And that says a lot with both your boys being Division I quarterbacks as well. What can you say about how big he's been for this program here at Rabun County?
Yeah, you can talk about 12,000 yards, 170 touchdowns, mm-hmm. his winning percentage at Rabun County. You can talk about all those things. But what he's got that so many don't have is he's a winner.
Mm-hmm.
And when I say that, he wills a win in games, and he brings everybody else's level of play up. And everybody believes, and he's just such a winner. He's ultra competitive, but it's his will to win just drives everybody to a different level.
Mm-hmm.
And as talented as he is in everything else, how he throws a football from different launch points, and he's not a robot, and he makes things happen. And you see quarterbacks like Baker Mayfield and the quarterback at UCF that was playing it almost identical. Bailey Fisher was the same kind of kid, mm-hmm. same kind of build, same kind of winner, same kind of, he's special.
Yeah.
And he's written a legacy here in Rabun County that hopefully somebody else will be the next guy up to be that name.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, definitely. He's definitely left his mark here. And he kind of generated, you know, the key cog to that machine for the offense, 684 yards of offense, sixth most all time for any team. So 21 years of coaching, an incredible offense that you had. But a lot of times that kind of overshadowed the defense. And they were spectacular this year. What can you say about those guys?
Yeah, well, going back to Bailey, you got to have a catalyst. You got to have somebody that's a catalyst on that team that everybody kind of rallies around and brings their game up. Our defense, phenomenal. I mean, it's not coach talk and it's not cliche, you know, about defense wins championship. It really, truly does win championships. And I like the fact that our defense kind of gets overlooked at times,
mm-hmm.
because it puts a chip on their shoulders.
Yeah.
And it's kind of a no-name defense, and you kind of like that. They don't get a lot of attention, and they really don't strive for a lot of attention. It's just watch us play.
Yeah.
You know, watch us get after you. Watch us go on the hunt. And it's fun to watch those guys get after it on Friday nights.
Absolutely. It's ball hawks. I mean, I've never seen a team fly to the ball so quick.
Well, you know, it all comes down to this, I believe, is relentless effort. And I believe it. Urban Meyer talked about this. Getting from point A to point B as fast and as hard as you can. Every play, every rep. And it makes you look a lot faster than what you are, because clockwise, I don't know how fast we really are,
mm-hmm.
but getting to point A to point B with urgency,
yeah,
we're as good as anybody.
Yeah, and I think that's why what amazes me about your program is that you lock and load, you know. I mean, you don't replace a Bailey Fisher, generational talent. But I remember a couple of years ago also, we were talking about what you called life without Charlie Warner. Mm-hmm. Now we're looking at potentially life without Bailey Fisher. But what I love about this program is it seems like you have built it to where it's designed for that next man up to come in and be able to succeed.
Well, everybody gets to write their own story. You know, we don't have to have a story about Charlie Warner again or a story about Bailey Fisher again. You know, I really feel that there's another story on the way that's already started being written a few years ago. It's a story about Austin Jones. Mm-hmm. There's your next story. In my opinion, I've always said that he's a smaller version of Charlie Warner, and he's going to write his own story for Raven County and leave a legacy as well. So it's the next guy up, and it's always fun to see who that guy's going to be.
Yeah.
Because I enjoy putting the pieces of the puzzle back together and seeing who that catalyst is going to be for your football team.
That's going to be a lot of fun. Well, Coach, I look forward to next year already. I'm already chomping at the bit. I know you are, to get back out there and make another deep run, and let's get back to the state championship.
Well, you know, I talked about decompressing for about 2 weeks after it was over with, and it took me about 12 hours, 4 hours scratching notes on the pad again. So
I'm sure.
We're all excited about it. It was a phenomenal season for Raven County. We didn't feel like it was a Cinderella story. We felt like we earned it.
Mm-hmm.
And we did. We earned the right to be where we were at, and it wasn't a fluke or by mistake or by chance. It was the fact that we went out and got it, and this next class will be the same.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Coach. Really appreciate it.
I appreciate you.